Well, good afternoon, everyone, and a very, very warm welcome to the Musical Museum here at Kew Bridge in London, England. It's a great pleasure to have you with us once again for our second live-streamed concert. Now, as you can see, I've got the best seat in the house. That's mainly because there's only me in the house, but that doesn't matter because we're in for an afternoon of wonderful, wonderful music. Now, before we get to the music, I just want to take the opportunity to say a very, very big thank you to all of you who have written into the museum with comments and questions and some wonderful feedback on the streamed events that we've already done. And this will be continue to be a very significant feature of life here at the Musical Museum. I will be doing an interview with Richard Hills, which will be subsequent to today's performance. So I hope you'll tune into that, as I hope you'll tune into next month's performance. So please keep an eye out on our website and on our social media for details of the next streamed event. And of course, you can also subscribe to our Patreon page. A lot of you have chosen to do that, which is hugely appreciated by us here in the museum. It all goes to help keeping this wonderful museum and our wonderful Wurlitzer up and running and open and available for future generations. Anyway, enough of the chat from me. I'm going to sit back in the best seat in the house and enjoy this afternoon's music. So, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are in the world, and thank you if you are tuning in, as I know some of you are from Australia and New Zealand and Canada and the United States, it's great to have you with us. So sit back with me and enjoy the wonderful music of the wonderful Mr. Richard Hills.
Strange experience for me sitting here playing to an almost empty concert hall. So often when we play these instruments in concert, we enjoy a rapport, with any luck, with the audience. But today it's a little bit different, and so I'm mindful of perhaps those broadcasting cinema organists from the 1920s and 30s who quite often would play to an empty house in the middle of the night for Empire transmissions. And so wherever you are in the world listening today, thank you for joining us, and I hope you'll enjoy the tones of this very distinctive Wurlitzer organ, one of the most distinctive sounding instruments built by that company, I'm sure many of us will agree, and also an instrument which has a wonderful heritage of broadcasting, so all the more appropriate to be here this afternoon. Now, it's a long time since I last played a theatre organ. Beginning of January, I seem to remember, so who knows, I might be ever so slightly rusty. Let's hope not, fingers crossed. And if you can ooze your goodwill across the ether, that would be really good. Now, we started with La Vie en Rose, as I'm sure many of you will have recognized, and I'm mindful of the wonderful comeback show that Gracie Fields presented, where she began with that, singing the immortal lines, "Take me to your hearts again." I thought it would be appropriate to start with that. And although perhaps these days I'm known for playing with what you might call a bit of a transatlantic style, that being to say that I love the stylings from the USA as well as from Britain, my background is very much in this country, and in fact it will surprise some of you to learn that until about the age of 10 I used to play with quite a strong Blackpool accent, but there we are, life goes in different directions, doesn't it? But I've still always maintained my love of the great British style of playing, and so perhaps understandably this afternoon, in combination with with this Wurlitzer, I thought we'd sort of err on that side of the Atlantic. And so, very traditional to start with, we're going to have three things in quick succession to keep the chatter down to a minimum. The first of them is a great British march called Imperial Echoes, which, if he's watching, I'd like to dedicate to my friend Andrew Barham, who loves all things marchy. And then a concert waltz called Knights of Gladness, which was a big favourite. And a little nod to the great Joseph Seal after that, with a selection of music from the pen of Ivor Novello. I used to love listening to his LP record, that dates me a bit, doesn't it, called Joseph Seal Plays the Music of Ivor Novello, and I've always thought Novello's music works particularly well on this instrument with its dark crooning kind of sound. So we'll have a selection of music from Ivor Novello, but preceding that, Imperial Echoes and Knights of Gladness. Here we go, fingers crossed, hope you'll enjoy the music.
Thank you. Thank you.
Music by Ivan Novello, and if I can read my scribble here, you heard some music from The Dancing Years, Lorelei, High Women Love from Perchance to Dream, Fly Home, Little Heart, Uniform, We'll Gather Lilacs in Spring, Bees Are Buzzin', The Leap Year Waltz, and Shine Through My Dreams. Wonderful music, which I love to play, and sometimes you think it's sort of, these days, the preserve of theatre organist, that music, but it works so well, and I enjoy playing it, and I hope you enjoyed listening too. Well, we're going to move on now to a couple of contrasting pieces, both of which were written by theatre organists, and those of you who have been to my concerts before know that I like to do that. It's nice to keep their memory alive, and so many of them were fine composers as well as fine instrumentalists. And we're going to start with a gentleman called Frederick Baco, Freddie Baco, who was a very popular resident organist at the the Dominion in Tottenham Court Road here in London for several years, before going off becoming, amongst other things, chairman of the Light Music Society, and a favourite with EMI, the gramophone company, who recorded him at a number of locations, including one of the last commercial recordings at the Regal Marble Arch with its famous Christie, and a subsequent follow-up album at the Gaumont State Kilburn Wurlitzer, an instrument which happily is still, I understand, very much in situ. So here is a piece of his from his orchestral output, arguably his most famous composition, and it's a delightful little pastiche called Elizabethan Mask. It will give us a chance to show off some of the more piquant sounds in the organ. And after that, a piece which I've resurrected after quite some years. I used to play it quite a lot and then retired it, and I thought I would bring it out to play for you this afternoon. It's by popular Midlands organist Jack Hellier, who for many years was both resident organist and manager of the Ritz Cinema in Nottingham. And I'm not very aware of very many of his compositions, but this one seems to be quite well known. It's called Brush Off, no offence intended. So two compositions by British theatre organists, Frederick Baco's Elizabethan Mask, and then Jack Hellier's Brush Off.
Thank you.
what a fun piece, eh? Jack Hellier's Brush Off, and before that, the charming Elizabethan Masque by Frederick Bacot. Well, it's been a bit of a sad time, obviously for many reasons, this year, but last year also was sad in terms of the loss of one of the great names of the entertainment world, Doris Day. She was in so many things, some of which tunes from which she made particularly famous, some of which are a little bit more obscure, some of which she covered, but either way, always a consummate artist and a great favourite. And to mark the sad occasion of her passing, I put together a little selection of music called Doris Day Delights, which feature some of her most famous songs. So let's see how many of them you can recognise.
Thank you.
Well, it is Sunday after all, isn't it? And just before coming here, I was playing for the Sunday Mass at St Mary's Bourne Street, so I thought I would put in something a little bit more religious to mark the day of the week, and what better on this Wurlitzer, which has such a fine classical organ sound makeup with all of these wonderful chorus reeds, than the Holy City. And just sitting there playing that made me think that one of the most useful stops we have on this organ is a stop called the French trumpet, which I know that many of our American friends are intrigued about, because it's not a stop commonly found on Wurlitzer organs outside the UK. And it's this one here. Sort of a nice little cornopian sound, and it sounds particularly effective down in the tenor register with the tremulant or the vibrato. It gives that lovely Joseph Seal-style croon. As well as contributing tremendously to the build-up of the full organ sound. Well, the top of the hour is almost upon us, believe it or not. It's flown by. I've really enjoyed this slightly disconcerting experience playing to the ether, but I very much hope you've enjoyed the programme. And if you have, please do consider supporting the work of the museum, who preserve these wonderful instruments, but don't just keep them as museum exhibits in glass cages. They really use them and make them relevant for today. And so please do consider supporting their work by whichever means you feel appropriate. I'm sure there's a link where you can donate a few shekels. And I'm going to leave you very shortly to finish your Sunday lunches and maybe enjoy your glasses of claret or lemonade or whatever it is that you happen to be having at the moment. And so thank you very much to the museum for all of their kind support and encouragement for the programme here today. It's been great to be back at a horseshoe console again after all this time, particularly, as I said at the beginning, one which has such strong connections with broadcasting and the sound world of the theatre organ in this country. And isn't it wonderful to find the instrument absolutely original, down to its original electro-pneumatic relays and combination action? You can hear that characteristic thump as I hit the pistons. And all of that is such a joy to use and to make music with here at the museum. It's all part of the instrument's heritage. So with heritage in mind, I'm going to leave you now with a couple of pieces. Both of them composed by Harold Ramsey. Now, his name perhaps is slightly falling from memory, but back in the 1930s, he was a tremendously popular broadcaster and entertainer and indeed composer, as we're about to hear. And he was based at the Regal Kingston, where this organ came from, for some time. And I believe it was from there that his popular Radio Rodeo broadcasts originated, sort of a magazine program introducing star turns, as they would say in the club world. And I'd like to remember Harold Ramsey to close today. The first piece is a little bit more gentle, just as a contrast to the Holy City. It's a beautiful little ballad called Her Name is Mary. And to finish, a wonderful march called the Rodeo March in honor of Radio Rodeo. And this one is particularly fun because it has its middle section in two time signatures. Those of you who like your marches will know that marches are, with any luck, usually in 6/8 time or in 2/4 time. And the middle section of this is in both. Not at the same time, I hasten to add. That would be a little bit too Benjamin Britten. But they switch back and forth seamlessly. So the Rodeo March will finish things off today after we've heard from Her Name is Mary. So, once again, thanks for joining. Wherever you are zoning in from, it's been a joy, and I hope you'll come back and consider supporting this series of events here at the famous Wurlitzer organ here at Kew Bridge. Thanks very much, and good afternoon.
Thank you.